Computing a Pearson correlation in JASP is a simple but rewarding procedure. So let's learn how to conduct a simple correlation, how to interpret it, and how to write it up in APA style. We will be using the dataset about burnout and job satisfaction called JobSatisfaction.csv. These are data from 200 mental health counselors. The variables in the dataset are job satisfaction score, how much you like your job, burnout score, compassion fatigue, turnover intention, which is your intention to leave the job, gender, coded as male or female, and compassion satisfaction. Compassion fatigue is the negative emotional consequence of helping people who have been traumatized or have lived through something traumatic. It affects people in the helping professions, first responders, nurses, counselors, and so on. Compassion satisfaction, by contrast, is the positive emotional consequence of helping people who have been traumatized. So a therapist who helps others might either become burned out from vicariously experiencing the trauma of others, or might feel a sense of pride and personal satisfaction from helping. So both compassion fatigue and compassion satisfaction can affect job satisfaction of mental health counselors. Burnout is a loss of enthusiasm for a job that can be experienced in any job setting, not just the helping professions. But compassion fatigue is theorized to be a specific form of burnout that is unique to helpers. What are the theoretical relationships between compassion fatigue, compassion satisfaction, burnout, and job satisfaction? Let's focus on job satisfaction. If a therapist has high levels of burnout, they hate their job, will job satisfaction likely be high or low? As burnout increases, you would expect that job satisfaction would be lower. There is an inverse or negative relationship. What about compassion fatigue? If a therapist has high levels of compassion fatigue, you would expect that job satisfaction would be lower because compassion fatigue is theoretically a form of burnout. Again, there is an inverse or negative relationship between these variables. On the other hand, we would expect that higher levels of compassion satisfaction would correlate with increased levels of job satisfaction. There is a direct or positive relationship between these variables. What about the relationship between compassion fatigue and burnout? As I said, compassion fatigue is theorized to be a specific form of burnout that only affects people in the helping professions. So, because they are similar constructs, you would expect that as compassion fatigue increased, you would see an increase in burnout. They should move in the same direction because they are kind of the same thing. At least, that's what the theory says. So let's find out. Let's walk through the five steps of hypothesis testing. Step one, select the appropriate statistic. We are measuring the strength and direction of a relationship between two variables, so we will use the Pearson correlation. Step two, state the null and alternative hypothesis. The null hypothesis is that the population correlation is zero for each pair. So we write H sub zero colon rho equals zero, where rho is the Greek letter for lowercase r. The alternative hypothesis is H sub one colon rho does not equal zero. Step three. Select a level of significance. For a two-tailed test, alpha of 0.05, 198 degrees of freedom, that is the number of pairs, 200 minus 2, the critical value is 1.98. Now, this is calculated from a t-table, just like we used for our t-tests. You will notice that this critical value is very close to 1.96 because our sample size is so very large. So step four, calculate the statistics, and for that, we turn to JASP. Begin by placing the dataset JobSatisfaction.csv on your computer desktop. We open our dataset by clicking on the main menu icon in the upper left corner. It looks like the stack of pancakes. And then selecting Open, Computer, Desktop, JobSatisfaction.csv. And then clicking Open. We will begin by looking at our data. The variables imported mostly correctly. I will make one change to the random ID variable, which is a string of numbers that serve as an identifier. It's really a nominal or a naming variable. On the left edge of the box, we can click here to change column type and set it to nominal. The rest of the variables are set to scale, which you can see by the yellow ruler icon next to their names. Both gender and marital status are treated as nominal variables, or factors. So let's set those levels. For gender, hover over the name of the variable and click here to change labels. For this research, male was coded as 1. And female was coded as 2. Now click on marital. Marital status was coded as 1 equals married and 2 equals unmarried. Those are all of the settings that we need to change. Now we are ready to do the analysis. To do a Pearson's correlation, begin by clicking on Regression, and then under Classical, choose Correlation. Remember that correlation is a special case of regression, and that both are part of the general linear model, in which we model our data using a straight line. This is why correlation can be found under Regression. Move the variables Job Satisfaction, Burnout, and Compassion Fatigue into the variables window. The option for Pearson correlation is set by default. In other examples, we would choose Spearman's Row or Kendall's Tau. The alternative hypothesis is a two-tailed test. It is not positively correlated or negatively correlated. Significant correlations in either direction will be important to us. We want to flag significant correlations. And sample size will be important for the APA write-up. Let's look at the results so far. This table shows us the correlational coefficient for each pair of variables and their significance values. What we see is what we expect. We see that job satisfaction is negatively correlated to burnout. As burnout goes up, job satisfaction goes down. We also see that burnout is positively correlated to compassion fatigue. They both increase together. The relationship between job satisfaction and compassion fatigue is also negative, but it is not as strong. This table is called a correlation matrix. Because each variable correlates with itself at a positive 1, and this is not very interesting because every variable correlates with itself at a positive 1, those correlations are not reported. Instead, we see only a line. We also see blank spaces in the upper right, rather than reporting the same correlations twice. So the only correlations we need are in the lower left. This table is the traditional correlation matrix. but JASP gives us a more elegant display as well. Click on Display Pairwise. We now see each pair of variables correlated, the same information as the previous matrix, but more simply displayed. You can use either table, but I prefer this one. In either view, if a correlation is statistically significant, JASP will flag that correlation and notate it with 1, 2, or 3 asterisks. The number of asterisks indicates the level of significance. It will also include a note under the table as to what those asterisks mean. In this case, 3 asterisks means this correlation is significant at a p less than 0.001 for a two-tailed test. But you know what we need? We need some visuals. Let's get some scatter plots by clicking on Scatter Plots under Plots. Nice plots, right? Remember that one of the features of JASP is progressive disclosure. You can click on other options to see what they do, and then unclick them. Nothing that you click will mess up your analysis. And this is a really good way to learn about the features in the software. For example, untick the Display Pairwise option. The scatter plots now change to a matrix. Now, I don't care for this display. I like the separate plots. So I would tick Display Pairwise, and I would be able to see the plots separately. I can change the size of the plots individually. And I can copy a scatter plot to the clipboard and then later on paste it into my research article. The variables are listed by their names, so if I wanted to change the plot labels, I would have to go back to my original dataset, edit it, and then rename them there. I might also want to know about the 95% confidence intervals around these estimations. And I could ask for the Volk-Selke maximum p-ratio. So what is this? All p-values are not created equal. The Volk-Selke maximum p-ratio gives us a way to assess the diagnosticity of our p-value. It helps us to interpret the correlation. I would like to make a standalone video about this, but I'm still learning about it myself, and I'm working on explaining it to others. So in the meantime, I've included a link to a cartoon explanation of the procedure in the video description. We can also get more information about our plots. Add the densities for variables. This adds histograms that show us the distribution of each variable pair. The statistics option shows us the correlations for each pair. The heat map again shows us a simple correlation matrix with correlations indicated by color based upon their relative strength. Blue colors correspond to positive correlation coefficients. Red colors correspond to negative correlation coefficients. The saturation of the colors reflects the absolute value of the correlation coefficient. Look at these options to see what they do, and then when you're done, untick the additional options and go back to our original settings. And finally, remember that if you ever need information about what each of these options does, you can click on the blue eye to show info for analysis. Returning to our 5 steps of hypothesis testing, we are ready to calculate the statistics. But because we have so many correlations, these will go better in a table. We will be able to copy this table directly from JASP. Step 5 is to make the decision. But again, some correlations may be significant, while other correlations are not, so we will want to write up the correlations that are most important for our research question. We would report the results in APA style like this. We would mention the type of test and the purpose of the research. Notice that in APA style, you do not capitalize the names of the variables. Next, we would report important correlations, including R, degrees of freedom in parentheses, the coefficient, and its significance value. The degrees of freedom is n minus 2, where n is the number of pairs for that correlation. Each of our correlations was for 200 pairs, so the degrees of freedom are 198. Because I was interested in the relationship between burnout and the other two variables, I reported only those correlations. But I included a table with all of the other correlations, and I will create a scatter plot for burnout and job satisfaction. This would be a good time to remind you that the APA publication manual states that no single correlation is worthy of a publication all by itself. In other words, if you correlate only two variables, don't expect to publish that. It is a good exercise for a class, but not important enough to advance the science in your field. The solution is to make your research design more robust and measure more than just two variables. Returning to the interpretation, I might also mention what some findings suggest, something I will explore further when I write up the discussion section, and mention the effect sizes in the form of R squared. I would also explain what those effect sizes imply. I have two options for tables. I could create an APA-style table out of the correlation matrix like this. Because every variable correlates with itself at a positive 1, use a 1 or a dash in those spaces, or just leave them blank, which is what I did here. Also, report each correlation only once. That is why the boxes on the lower left of the table are all blank. In this example, I used abbreviations for the variables in the column headers, but I defined them with the variable names. You could also simply repeat the names of the variables in the headers, use numbers, or use abbreviations and then define them in a note below the table. Finally, I used the JASP convention of 3 asterisks for correlations significant at the 0.001 level, and I included the meaning of the asterisks in a note below the table. My second option is to report the pairwise correlations in a single APA-style table like this. One of the really handy features in JASP is the ability to create publication-ready tables and figures. I would copy the scatter plot from the results window and paste it into my report. And that is how we compute and report a Pearson correlation in JASP.